And joining us on Hot Copy, we have Comelec Commissioner George Garcia. Commissioner Garcia, good morning to you, sir.
Good morning, Ma'am Karen, and good morning to all the televiewers.
All right. I want to ask for the status right now of the investigation with Comelec Director James Jimenez and Arabe. What are the results so far?
Ma'am Karen, I would like to clarify that until today, the investigation hasn't been terminated, still ongoing. It has not been concluded. If there is any, it's just an initial recommendation by Commissioner Ray Bulay before going into a full-blown fact-finding investigation. But so whatever was the recommendation made, it's not yet accepted or there's no action yet from the Comelec chairman, our own chairman. At the same time, it was not even referred to the Comelec and bank. So until today, we'd like to clarify that Director James Jimenez remains to be our official spokesperson, mm-hmm. and he remains to be the Director of Education and Information Department, and Director Arabe remains to be likewise the Deputy Director of said department.
Okay, so I think that's very important because all the articles I've read, it seems almost that James is already relieved from his post.
No, Ma'am Karen, contrary to this, accusation, allegation, but Director James Jimenez was even the one who spearheaded the walkthrough last Saturday in the transparency server for media at the UST. So andyan pa rin po siya. Wala pong nagbabago in the meantime sa commissioner election. He is still the face of the Comelec, the official spokesperson of the commissioner election.
Okay. And I'm curious, with just 1 week to go before election day, do you believe that Mr. Jimenez will be retaining his post, considering there will be a lot of work on hand because of elections, essentially, and a lot of questions?
Yes, ma'am. At this point, that should be very clear and evident that we cannot rock the boat at this time. At this point, we have to prepare for the election. 8 days to go before the election. Whatever investigation, whatever things happening in the commission, that will not affect definitely our preparation. In a very large organization such as the commission, it's just but natural that there will be this kind of internal happenings, but these internal happenings cannot and should not affect our preparation. We should focus on the election at all costs. This is a very important historic election, and therefore we will be blamed if there will be a problem in the election simply because we have something like this in the commission. So focus on the election at all costs.
Okay. And just for the record, the Comelec did not release any amount of money. I mean, I interviewed Commissioner Abula, he did say that walang inilabas na pera ang Comelec sa Impact Hub.
I confirm, ma'am, yes, that's true. Not a single cent from the coffers of the commission went out. So therefore po, intact yung pera po namin. Wala po kaming nabigay o nabayaran.
Pero for future purposes, hindi ba dapat talagang may pera at pondo ang Comelec to spend for your own debates?
Well, ma'am, in accordance with the Republic Act 9006, just like what happened, and I know you participated in the 2016 debates, it should really have been the ideal is that it should have really been the major networks that will be conducting the debates. The Comelec will just be there just to supervise, and it will be the major networks that will spend, and they are allowed under even the law and our Comelec resolution to sell commercial rights during the conduct of the debate. That was what happened in the 2016 election, but then that did not happen now in the 2022 presidential and vice presidential debate.
Okay, so my last question is, it's been a question on everybody's mind. Why wasn't it bidded out? Why was Impact Hub chosen? I know that investigations are still ongoing, but is there an initial reason at least that you would know?
No initial reason at all, Ma'am Karen. I am still waiting for the conduct of the investigation being conducted by Commissioner Ray Bulay. It's indeed that we should go deeper. We should go to the source. We should really ask the question, why? Why did this happen? And what started it all? When did it all begin? And so we are all waiting for the investigation of Commissioner Bulay to clarify everything, not only for this election, but likewise for purposes of the future, so that again, we will not be again in the same mess that we have been in. Buti na lang po, we were saved by the KBP in this particular mess.
Okay. Now, I'm curious, are there sectors in Comelec calling for the resignation of James Jimenez and Arabe?
I have not heard of any complaint sector calling for resignation. Wala naman po. We are all focused on the investigation. That's why what happened, transpired last week, was really a bombshell. We were so shocked that because of the news. But just the same, it will not interrupt any preparation.
Okay. Why continue even? I mean, I saw the list. You have the major candidates who have already not participated. Vice President Lenny Robredo has declined. Isko Moreno has declined. Aping Lacson has declined. Why even go through it?
Because it is our commitment, and likewise the KBP committed, that it is not only for one person, it is not only for one or two or three candidates, it is for the entire candidate. So even if only one candidate will agree and to proceed with a panel interview, we will proceed. It is our commitment likewise to the Filipino people. They have to know their candidates. 1 hour is 1 hour, and therefore that is enough for them to at least maybe change their minds, or at least to strengthen or cement their choice already. And at the same time, to even perhaps look into these candidates who may not be high in surveys, but just the same, they're offering themselves to the people. Mm. Perhaps we can likewise listen to them and listen to what they want for the country and their vision for our country.
Okay. Now, you're a newly appointed commissioner. I'm curious. You're probably there, I'm assuming, for the next 6 years. Am I correct?
7 years, Ma'am Karen.
Seven years. So you will still be in the Comelec when the next presidential elections happen. What do you believe should be changed? I have heard of some people saying that there should be a stricter policy, really, when it comes to declaring nuisance candidates.
Ma'am Karen, just in case, I will be confirmed. I mean, not yet confirmed. My appointment
but
is just
yes.
In the event, just in case, we have to change, overhaul the election laws presently. Uh-oh. It's 1985, Sir Ma'am Karen. 1985 pa po yung election laws that we have the 1987 Constitution. Try to imagine maybe a batasang pambansa pa na binabanggit sa election. We have to overhaul. We have to even include the debates, whether national or local. We have to compel the candidates to appear and attend, and we can impose sanction. And at the same time, we can say when you file your candidacy, you're already covered by the election law, meaning under the present setup, when you file your candidacy, you are not yet considered candidate according to the case of Peñera versus Comelec. Mm-hmm. You will only be considered a candidate on the first day of the campaign period. Try to imagine that scenario. Gumagastos na yung kandidato, nakikipagkamay na, tapos namimigay na kung ano. They are not yet covered by any election. They are not violating. There is no premature campaigning. So at the same time, we have to change already sa campaign finance. 3 pesos per registered voter, come on. 3 pesos per registered voter, and then 5 pesos per political party and party list, and then 10 pesos per president and vice president, regardless as to whether they have a political party or not. We have to adjust. Mm-hmm. We have to adjust to the changing times. But at the same time, how can you have an election law applicable for manual election when you are already computerizing the election? So completely, madaming problem na po. Likewise, you have to include a revision entirety of our party list law. Because the Supreme Court had been saying they're being compelled to legislate. You call that judicial legislation simply because the law is lacking. Mm-hmm. So dapat po kumpletuhin na nating lahat so that by 2025 and then 2028, everything now is in order because we have now the laws by which the public can implement.
All right. So that would be some of your recommendations. Let's talk about this elections. You do have people complaining, number one, of some technical issues. There are technical concerns. But let's start with a Comelec precinct finder. There is a column written by no less than former Justice Artemio Panganiban, the former Chief Justice, saying that the Comelec should just frankly withdraw its precinct finder. It's complicated. It does not work. And just move on to just the local aspect. He says it's useless.
Yeah, Ma'am Karen, we know where the Honorable former Chief Justice Artemio Panganiban is coming from. We highly, highly respect his opinion on this matter. But however, the precinct finder is just not, it's not the end of everything. It's just a mode by which you can find out whether you are still a registered voter, what is the state of your registration. Hindi naman po yun ang katapusan ng lahat. We still have the voter's information sheet to be distributed, being distributed nationwide. As of present, we have 43 million nationwide distributed. In Region 1, in the Cordillera, 100% na po yung distribution namin ng voter's information sheet. In Metro Manila, we have in NCR, 51% as of last Friday. What are these voters' information sheets? This contain your name, your voting precinct, your polling place.
Yeah.
And this will be distributed by Comelec personnel, not by barangay officials, not by the LGUs, by the Comelec personnel. It contains the do's and don'ts of voting, and it contains the names of the candidates, national and local. So this is very, very important. We did not do that in 2019 or perhaps even in 2016. So aside from the voters, the precinct finder, we have the voters' information sheet, we have the voters' assistance desk at the entrance of each polling place, and we have the list of voters at the in front of the polling precinct, and we have the list of voters inside the polling precincts. Kung hindi pa po sapat yon, maybe at this point you can go to the local Comelec. It's already available. The 90 day the requirement that it should be available already, we already complied 90 days before the election, available to all our local offices.
Okay, so with all of that, with all of those options, why do you believe is the precinct finder still helpful, considering you have all these complaints where you have people that are active voters and ang lumalabas, no record found? Palagay niyo, bakit kailangan pa po ang precinct finder?
Because madami pong nakinabang din doon sa precinct finder na yan. Alam din po natin, we are full aware in the commission, definitely, as to the problems encountered, simply because the voter perhaps clicked that a different spelling or misspelled the name, or did not include, just like an instance, did not include the junior, or even included the junior without a period, or maybe perhaps to a certain extent, our local Comelec, which happens to be the source of this list, ay nagkamali po sa pag-encode ng names. But all of these things, we can always correct. We are saying our information technology department is all available. You can just inquire from the Comelec website, and they will immediately answer you. Whatever your problem, you cannot find your record, we can find that to you, because our information department will always make the necessary click, and then makikita at makikita po. So okay, we are always giving that assistance to everyone.
All right. Now, former CJ Panganiban also received a printed handout. It was given to his household, the voter information sheet, detailing some questions: name, address, precinct number, name and location, voting center. Bakit po natanggap niya yon? Ang ibang tao walang ganon. I've never received something like that and the whole time I've been voting.
Yes, ma'am. Before, wala po talaga napapabigay. O before po kasi siguro yung naging strategy ng mga former sa Comelec before is to let the barangay distribute it. Our strategy now is definitely not. Mapupoliticize po kasi kapag pinadistribute natin sa barangay o sa LGU, especially kung kalaban si Ma'am Karen, so why should you give that voters information to him? Now we would like to target 100%. Maybe the reason why you have not yet received, indeed, because nga po in Metro Manila, napakadami po kasing tao dito. But sa Metro Manila, as of last Friday, 51% na po yung nabigyan namin. Siguro po kasama si former Chief Justice Panganiban na
so
nabigyan.
So Comelec yun. Did you send that by mail? How did it work? Sent by mail or by hand?
No, ma'am. By hand, personal, by our Comelec people. We employed a lot of several number of people nationwide just for the sake of distributing personally to the voters. Or kung hindi man po, you're living in a condominium or living in a subdivision, it will be given to the association or will be given to your lobby so that they will be the one to distribute it to the unit owners.
Okay, but what about voters? You're talking about the DE, that's like 48 million of all the registered voters. Binigyan rin sila ng voter information sheet?
We are targeting 67.4 million nationwide, Ma'am Karen. As of today, as of last Saturday, 43 million na po of the 67.4 million yung nabibigyan nationwide. In Metro Manila, it's only 51% of the total number of registered voters as of last Saturday. Hopefully, until Wednesday, you'll be able to receive your own voters' information sheet, Ma'am Karen, because we would like to jack up from 51%.
No, I voted already, sir. Alam mo yon. I voted already, the absentee voting, but I'm just curious. For example, will everybody getting this? Ano to, Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, or Manila
yes,
lang
ma'am.
To?
Paano? Nationwide. Nationwide po, Ma'am Karen. In fact, in CAR, Cordillera, and in Region 1, and in Region 3, 100% na po sila doon na distribution ng voters' information sheet. In Metro Manila lang po, medyo naging mabagal, 51%.
Okay. But so, Commissioner, paano yung mga mahihirap na hindi nakatira sa permanenteng bahay? Walang permanent address, pero bumoboto or lilipat ng presinto. Paano po yun?
Unfortunately po, the houses or the addresses as contained in their registration record will be the place where the voters' information sheet will be delivered. Siyempre, hindi naman po alam nung mga magdi-distribute namin kung saan na sila lumipat o kung saan talaga yung permanent address nila. Whatever is declared in the voters' registration, that will be the address that of which the BIS will be distributed or will be sent. So ganun po yung procedure natin. I mean, we are fully aware that several people with several houses or several residences at the same time, but whatever is contained in the registration record, that will be the list that we'll be following.
Okay. Now, of course, we are voting in a post-COVID era, so to speak, but COVID still present. Ikwento po ninyo, ano bang magiging kaibahan? Alam ko magbubukas ng mas maaga ang presinto. Will there be certain protocols pag bumoboto po tayo ngayon?
Yes, Ma'am Karen. 6 to 7 po. Alas 6 ng umaga, pwede na pong bumoto. So 6 o'clock pa lang po start na. Bukas na po ang ating mga polling precincts hanggang 7 o'clock po ng gabi. Extension, nakadepende po sa amin yan. But in the meantime, it's 6 to 7 o'clock. Now, ito po, I would like to take advantage of this situation, of your program. Number one, hindi po kailangan ng RT-PCR, ng rapid antigen test. Hindi po kailangan, hindi po kayo i-require. Number two, hindi po kailangan ng vaccination card para makaboto. And number three, kahit wala pong face shield, hindi po required. Face mask lang po, okay na. Meaning, ang makakaboto on election day on May 9 ay yung ang pangalan nasa listahan, active ang registration, and number two, naka-face mask. Now, paano po yun? Sir, ako po'y may nararamdaman, may symptoms of perhaps COVID-19, inuubo, nilalagnat, sinisipon, may LBM. Question, can I be allowed to vote? The answer is yes. How about those with temperature 37.5 and above? Can they vote? The answer is yes. But instead of them voting in the regular precincts, they'll be voting in an isolation polling precinct. May mga naka-PPE po doon, dadalhin po sila doon, and all their ballots coming from their regular precincts will be taken and will be brought to the isolation polling precincts to be allowed to vote. Paano po kung COVID-19 positive? Pagkatapos may comorbidity, hindi naman nakikita, o COVID-19 positive, talaga may nakikita, can they be allowed to vote? Yes, so long as they're already in the polling places or polling precincts. However, those who are COVID-19 positive po na maaari nasa isolation facility or sa mga bahay nila, hindi sila pinapalabas, we cannot bring the ballots to them. And we cannot even compel the DILG, palabasin nyo yan para makaboto. Pero ma'am, for whatever reason, nakalabas sila. Yung mga COVID-19 positive, kahit ngayon confirmed na COVID-19, pero nakalabas po sila for whatever reason, then we will allow them to vote. We have no choice.
I see. So that's quite clear. Kumbaga, hypothetical to ha. Let's say you know COVID-19 positive ka, nagpapahinga ka sa bahay, pero you just will not give up or miss your right to vote. Pag lumabas ka ng bahay, pwede mong gawin, hindi ka pwede, kumbaga, hindi ka pwedeng pilitin na bumalik.
Hindi pwede. Maybe the barangay po, because we have Republic Act 11332. Oh. Alam naman po natin, minomonitor yung mga may COVID. At the same time, meron tayong IATF protocol. But in the event na biglang nakalabas yung binabantayan yun, ma'am, tapos pumila sa presinto, we have no choice. The electoral boards does not know that this person is COVID-19 positive. Tinest, hindi naman siya 37.5 and above. Walang symptoms whatsoever.
Correct.
Pero may meron palang result na COVID-19 pa. Hindi naman po hahanapan siya doon.
Yeah.
And therefore, that person will be allowed to vote. Even, ma'am, the problem is that person will be allowed to vote in his regular precinct.
Mm-mm.
Kasi yung aming pong protocol lang is if the person has symptoms of COVID-19.
Pag nakita mo doon.
Tsaka mo dadalhin sa isolation polling precinct.
Okay, I have a question. So in all the precincts, bawal to add an additional layer of, let's say, checking. For example, can they suddenly have temperature checks before voting? Bawal yon.
Sa precinct, ma'am, no. Doon po sa entrance ng eskwelahan, sa may gate or whatever, meron po tayo, may temperature check po tayo doon.
And sino, who will be conducting those checks?
The Comelec, we have assistors, the Comelec people, na andun mismo. Sa ano, ma'am, yun, andun po yung sa may table. Uh-oh. We still have voters assistance desk. So before they can inquire as to whether they're registered voters or not, the temperature will be checked and find out if their temperature is 37.5.
Oh, basta ang clarification, if they're above 37.5, they cannot be turned away. They have to still be brought to another area to vote. Another question, will there be different protocols inside the voting classroom? Diba usually, eskwelahan po yan. Yung mga dati kong binobotohan, eskwelahan eh. Nagbawas ba kayo ng mga upuan? Is it, will it look different this coming May 9 or it's the same setup?
Definitely, Ma'am Karen. Sa loob po ng presinto, before, mga 10, misa nga, 15 pa yung pinapayagan. Yeah, yeah. Maybe, ngayon po, kalahati na lang po yung ating magiging...
Pero baka tumagal yun. Don't you think it tatagal yun?
Yes, ma'am. That's the reason why we likewise extended the voting hours from 6 to 7 o'clock because alam po natin, hahaba yung pila doon pa lang sa entrance because their temperatures will be checked and they will have to inquire doon sa list of voters doon sa desk. Of course, yung mahaba po yun. Pero yung pong sa number of voters that can vote at any given time, definitely time and motion, mga 5 to 7 minutes. But that's the reason why we are appealing to our voters. Just use the voters information sheet that you'll be using as your kodigo. Bring your kodigo so that hindi na po tayo mag-iisip doon. Pag nagdun pa tayo nag-isip, 5 to 7 minutes po eh. Pero pag may dala kayong kodigo, mga 3 minutes lang.
Actually, nagdala ko ng kodigo. Tama kayo dun, sir. Now, next question. Kasi yung absentee voting namin was manual, no?
Manual. Uh-oh. Yes, ma'am.
So I'm curious, do they have to bring their own ball pen?
No, ma'am. In this case, meron po tayo mga pen na sa mga chairs and it will be disinfected every now and then by the electoral board. So huwag po kayo magdadala ng mga pen na.
Okay, so na nakakabit na yung pen sa chair. And then what about cell phones? Because the other day you said in an interview, huwag na kayo mag-selfie sa loob ng presinto. But let's face it, you know, Filipinos will feel very proud na after nakaboto, they want to take a photo of themselves.
Yes, ma'am. We are not prohibiting the bringing of cell phones. Wala po sa guidelines namin. We're not even prohibiting you taking photos inside at least yourself, inside the polling precinct. However, as a practitioner before, maniwala po kayo sa mga botante natin, you will be questioned and your name will be included in the minutes. A watcher or an observer will complain and ang akala you are getting the picture taking the picture of your ballots. Bawal na bawal po in even your receipts. So perhaps in order to prevent that kind of scenario na you will be complained of, at the same time, you'll be included in the minutes and an election offense case will be filed against you. Just not use the cell phone. Bring the cell phone, it's okay. Or even perhaps, yung iba po ma'am, yung kodigo nasa cell phone eh. Huwag na lang po doon.
Bawal yun. I think you have to clarify that. Because when we did absentee voting, we were told na, sinabi ng Comelec, we had our cell phones, but then ang konti lang naman ng media inside the room. We were 6. But hindi pwedeng tignan ang kodigo sa cellphone. We could not look at our cell phones while voting. Yes, ma'am. Talagang we had to bring out the paper.
Yes, ma'am. Hindi naman bawal yung tingin mo yung cellphone. Kaya lang po, in actuality, what will really happen is of the watchers will object. Why? Because it is possible that while you are looking at your cellphone, kunyari, and then you are now getting a picture of the ballot. So, isipin niyo po yun, you will be complained of.
Or parang may pressure na make sure binoto mo to. May vote buying, pruweba na binoto mo to. So, that's the problem with the cellphone.
Yes, yeah. So in the final analysis, our instruction is you can bring cell phone, but please, while inside the polling precinct, refrain from using it. Outside, pagkatapos po, di pakita niyo yung inyong finger. Meron na po kayong ink. Okay lang po yun. Pero while inside, let's respect because of it's a formal thing that is happening inside. Okay. So there are several rules and regulation inside. Outside, it's a free for all, no problem.
Okay. Now, in terms of the lines outside, Will there be a different setup to that, for example? Because I remember in 2016 when I voted, you would have lines outside the classroom.
Yes, ma'am. Oh. Definitely, we have people po to ensure that the 1 meter social distancing is observed.
Ah, may ganun. Wow.
Yes, ma'am. Medyo kakaiba po talaga ngayon. In fact, our commissioner...
But isn't that a bit, I mean, honestly speaking, too late in the day? I mean, let's face it, sir, we saw the campaign footage. Wala naman social distancing yung mga tao doon. And then when you go to the mall, wala naman naka-social distance doon.
Yes, ma'am. But not as far as the Comelec is concerned. Remember, this election may be a super spreader event in the same manner that all campaign sorties may be a super spreader event. Kaya lang po, we do not want naman the Comelec to be the leader in as super spreader. As far as practicable and possible, we would like to maintain pa rin IATF guidelines and regulation observance, the DOH guidelines and regulation at the same time, and implementation of our health protocol. Mm-mm, so the Comelec would not like to be accused of violating this protocol. So kami, we will implement to the fullest these protocols and guidelines while inside the polling places.
Okay. Now, moving on to the security aspect of the elections. Last week, I interviewed CICC Executive Director Cesar Mancao. They arrested hackers who got access to a Smartmatic from an ex-employee. And of course, I think eventually, that ex-Smartmatic employee is now missing. But the question on everyone's mind is, these hackers are essentially promising, no? Or that's what they were planning. They would promise politicians that we can alter or change or manipulate the results of the elections. They did get voters' information. That's what the information that was leaked, because Mancao said on Headstart he saw voters' information that was all in the data. I mean, Commissioner, kaya ba talaga baguhin ang resulta? What do these hackers have?
No, ma'am. In fact, po, we are looking at the angle that itong mga na-arrest last week na tatlo, they are not even connected to the ones that we are looking for, the one that is a former employee of Smartmatic. Ang tawag po natin dyan, kahit na nagpa-practice ako, ma'am, hacker-hackeran eh. Sabi nila, hacker sila, sabi nila, kaya nila. Ang gagawin nila, they will go to the politician, 50 million, 70 million, campaign. Just give me an advance. We're going to buy equipment. We're going to buy somebody from the Commission of Election, from the Information Technology Department of the Comelec, and then pupunta sa kabilang grupo, sa kabilang kabilang party. Ay, the other party is offering us 100 million. We are offering you only 50. We believe that you'll be the one to win. So give us advance. So nakapag-advance sa parehas. Pag kung sino yung manalo, babalikan. See? You won. It's because of us. So sa natalo, well, the other party was able to pay a lot more than what we have paid. So ganun lang talaga, talo tayo. So why are these people having this data? Ma'am, in the Comelec, you can easily, even in our website, you can look in the website, there are data there. At the same time, your list of voters, you can secure the list of voters from the Comelec. You just file a formal petition or formal request to our executive director who happens to be the data privacy officer of the Comelec, and you can easily get that for a fee. Magbayad lang po kayo, kaya lang PDF files lang po yun. So, ang gagawin po nila, magsisecure sila ng ganyan, magre-request sila, lalagay nila sa laptop nila, pakikita sa mga kandidato, see? We were able to get into inside the system of the Commission of Election. In fact, these are easily, you can easily request this data. So, mga ano po ito, mga manloloko ng mga sindikato, and so therefore we can honestly say that our system is very secured. Ma'am, for the last since 2010, I have not proven a single ballot box having changed the result as an election practitioner, whether for the Protestant or Protestee. There was not a single ballot box of which we opened. And when we counted the ballots manually, that's the easiest way to check whether the machines are counting properly or not. There was not a single ballot box that I opened.
But then, Commissioner, let's talk about presidential frontrunner Bongbong Marcos's junior concern. Because it's interesting. I've heard in several campaigns, I've seen his campaign videos, and ginagawa na niyang biro sa mga supporters niya. O bibigyan ko kayong 3-in-1. Walang tulugan. simply because referring to the 2016 elections wherein it was a surprise to many. I was anchoring at that time. He was leading. And then give it 6 or 7 hours after, just overnight, then it was then candidate Lenny Robredo who took the lead. So clearly there were insinuations of possible cheating coming from maybe the administration and Comelec. So ano nangyari? You were a lawyer then.
Yeah, I was the lawyer of Senator Grace Po.
Yeah.
And I'm the lawyer of former Senator Bongbong Marcos in the election protest. But ma'am, now we can guarantee, and there's a guarantee from our steering committee, Comelec Commissioner Marlon Casquejo, that indeed this glitch, the 7-hour glitch, will no longer happen. It will no longer happen. We were able to determine the reason. Try to imagine, ma'am.
Yeah. What was the reason? Just say it in layman's terms. What was the reason for that 7-hour glitch?
Yes, ma'am. Yung transparency server sa Tagalog po natin, nabulunan. Sa sobrang dami ng pumapasok na data, kumbaga sa cellphone nyo, sabay-sabay ba namang nag-text yung lahat ng kaibigan nyo dahil birthday nyo, sabay-sabay. Hindi po lahat pumapasok kaagad. And therefore, minsan nagahang yung cellphone natin kahit yung pinakamagandang bago. Nagahang yung cellphone natin kasi po sa sobrang dami ng data na pumapasok, hindi niya kinaya. And but then, may pumapasok pong data. Kaya lang, from that cellphone, naka-mirror po yon sa mga media server, hindi nakakapag-push yung mismong server na ito, hindi nakakapag-push ng result sa mga media server, meaning sa mga laptop ng taga-ABS, taga-ANC, hindi sila nakakapag. Pero kita po ng mga media at that time na may pumapasok na data talaga sa server. Patuloy ang pagpasok, kaya lang po nagkaroon ng problema sa pag-push dito na po sa mga media servers, sa mga laptops po natin.
But then, what did the Comelec do this time? Was there an upgrade of some sort? Because clearly, the one thing is some analysts predict that this might end up like a 2016 issue between Mr. Marcos and Vice President Lenny Robredo.
So, yes, this time, we upgraded the system at the same time.
Okay.
From this server, the transparency server in UST, meron po kami nilagay na isang equipment na kung saan, by bulk, yung pagbagsak ngayon sa mga media server, yung sa laptop po ng mga media natin. Before po kasi, kahit sa manggaling na presinto, try to imagine you have 106,000 precincts nationwide. So kung 106,000, noon po 80,000 ngayon, 106,000. And then po papasok lahat doon sa transparency server. Tapos ibabato sa mga media server yung raw data, that will be problematic. This time, it will be by bulk ang pagbato po niya. First 10,000, then next 20,000, next 30,000. So it will practically solve the problem.
Okay. So what do you think, Commissioner, with this upgrade of the servers, do you believe that by the evening of May 9th, we already know who'll be winning as president? Or do you believe it's the next day, May 10th?
During the last 2016, it was si Ma'am Grace, we already considered in favor of President Duterte. So maybe because we already have knowledge because of the sending of the data, of the results. Ma'am, in the evening of May 9, perhaps not yet po. Evening of May 9, we can only proclaim the mayor. Siguro po early part of May 10, we can proclaim the congressman, the governor, the vice governor, and the sangguniang panlalawigan. And by that time, we already have an inkling of who is the winning presidential and vice presidential candidate. Take note that the official canvass of the president and the vice president will happen only on May 23 when Congress will resume its session June 3. But as far as the Comelec is concerned, perhaps we can canvass the result of the senators and the parties up to May 15. We can already proclaim the senators or the party list. The latest will be May 16.
Okay. Now, are you planning, kumbaga, is there the Comelec and Bank, do you have a certain goal or target that you want this election? Other than, of course, walang aberya is the declarations are faster.
Hopefully, yes, ma'am. Simply because we already improved the system. The overseas absentee, overseas voting will be here. The results will be here by May 9, May 10, more or less, after they have counted already. We already have set up the guidelines so that the ambassadors, the consuls will immediately bring the results. Now, we was able to improve the protocol in case the SD cards will malfunction or will be repaired. Instead of going to Santa Rosa, coming from Sulu or Basilan, Santa Rosa, Laguna. We already have established our provincial technical hubs to be manned by DICT and DOHT personnel.
So and that's the first time? First time, yan.
This is the first time. This is the first time, Ma'am Karen. And again, for the first time since 2010, we have shown to the public, to the media servers, the servers that will be the data servers that will be used in Parañaque, in Libis, in BGC for the first time. And nagkaroon ng walkthrough. And beginning today, all of these servers will be live streamed so everybody can see what is happening, who is going inside and out, going in the servers. So for the first time, ginawa natin to be transparent.
All right. Well, at least, I want to wish the Comelec luck and good luck to the Philippines. Good luck to us all. Is there anything you want to add, sir? Because I think we just have a few days left and then it's the big day.
To our voters, what you are voting is the future of your country, the future of your children and grandchildren. This is the best opportunity for us to at least improve and develop our country. We have to elect the rightful leader. At the same time, we have to vote. Hindi po mangyayari yung makakapaghalal tayo na hindi po kayo boboto. This is a constitutional right, and this is the only opportunity in this part of the world that we are all equal, whether you are rich or poor, old or young. We all have the same one single vote. So cast your vote on May 9.
All right. Comelec Commissioner George Garcia, thank you for joining me today, and you take care today, sir.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Welcome, and more power, Paul.